Today we are going to start with a new chapter, chapter number 4. It is called as Animal Kingdom. We have already finished with a Plant Kingdom. And now we are going to start with a chapter number 4. It's called as Animal Kingdom. Like a plant, there are also different varieties of animals that exist in this world. If we are trying to learn each and every living organism or the animal which are present on the world, then there are lots of living organisms we cannot study even this single year or 2 years. So what we have to do, we have to classify them based on their characteristic and the similarities and the dissimilarities. We are grouping them, and that what we are calling it as classification. And we will learn that phyla or the class from this classification which have a common characteristic. So we can come to know that so and so number of animals which are falling into a XYZ group have a same characteristic, and thus we can learn most of the living organism. Ultimately, the classification is the utmost need for characterizing and the learning the animals, all the animals. So we will learn the different classes and the phyla that falls under the animal kingdom. But for a classification, you should know the characteristics. You should know the parameters on which basis they are going to be classified. So today we will learn the different examples and their meaning in due to which the animals can be classified into a different phylum and the classes. Okay? So first of all, we will see the first characteristic on which the animals can be classified is the level of organization. Okay, this is the first criteria based on what the animals can be classified. This is called as level of organization. Which level of organization they have? Do they have cellular level of organization? Means they just have a cell. Do they have tissue level of organization? Means they have a tissues. Do they have organ level of organization? Okay, that means they have organs. And do they have an organ system level of organization? Okay, there are few animals which just have a cells. There are few animals in which the cells combine together form tissues. There are few animals in which there is a presence of organs. And there are also few animals in which there is a presence of organ system. So I will tell you the name of examples of phylum and the class which have a cellular level of organization. So here the example is, it is Porifera. This phylum Porifera, or you can say sponges, they have a cellular level of organization. Means they have just a cell. Not complex organization, they have very simple organization. Now the examples which have a tissue level of organization, then here the phylum is Coleoptera. Okay, this phylum has a tissue level of organization. Now, which phylum has organ level of organization? The example is Platyhelminths. Helminth means worm. So, this Platyhelminth is have an organ level of organization. And the organ system level of organization, the examples are phylum Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, and last is Chordata. So you just remember, sir, the phylum has which level of organization. If you remember this first lecture, then the whole chapter will be very easy for you. Okay? I know that you are learning this name for the first time, so it may happen that you might have a difficulties while learning this name. But when you repeat it for 2-3 times, then it will make it easier for you to remember this name. So which animal have a cellular level of organization? Those who fall under the phylum Porifera. Coleoptera has tissue level of organization. Platyhelminthes has organ level of organization. Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, and the Chordata, they have an organ system level of organization. So this is the level of organization. When we talk about the organ system, means they have a different system, like digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system, nervous system, endocrine system, many more. They have a system, but we in this system also there is also a deviation exists. So I will tell you, first one is regarding the digestive system. Okay, so the digestive system that you can find in this animal can be of two type. How many types of digestive system can be found? There are two types of a digestive system is found. The first is called as incomplete digestive system, and the second one is called as complete digestive system. There are two types of a digestive system is found, incomplete and the complete. I will first explain this complete because it is easier to understand, and then I will explain you the incomplete. Like the human being has the complete digestive system. So what do you mean by a complete digestive system? That means they have a two opening in a digestive system. The first one is a mouth through which they take the food, and the second one is an anus through which defecation process occurs. So they have a two opening. One opening of a digestive system is a mouth, and the second opening is an anus. Okay, so those animals who has a two opening in the digestive system, their digestive system is called as complete digestive system. So this is a complete digestive system. So what is the characteristic? They have a two openings. Which two openings are present in them? The first one is mouth and the second one is anus. These are the two openings you can find in them. So this is called as complete digestive system. This is called as complete digestive system. Which are the examples? The examples of animals which falls under the complete digestive system. All this: Annelida, Arthropoda, up to a chordata. That means all this: Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Chordata. If you are remaining or remembering this name in a sequence, then it is very easy for you to understand. Remember this sequence, because we also have to learn this in a sequence. As the level increases, we will learn by level. So it will be very easy. So from Annelida to Chordata, all these have complete digestive system. Means in their digestive system, there are two opening. Second, what is called as an incomplete digestive system? Incomplete digestive system, that means they have only just one opening. You can call it as mouth, you can call it as anus. There is a single opening through which they take up the food, and through this opening also they remove the waste. But here in human being there are two openings. But those animals which have a single opening in the digestive system or one opening in the digestive system, such digestive system is called as incomplete digestive system. And the example which falls under this, the example is, the animal which falls under it is Platyhelminthes. This Platyhelminthes has incomplete digestive system. Okay, so this is about the digestive system, those who are organ system. Another system which exists is a circulatory system. So the circulatory system in the animal which is found, they are also again two type. How many types? Two type. The first one is called as open circulatory system, and the second one is called as closed circulatory system. How many types? Two types: open and the closed circulatory system. What is a open circulatory system? Before I start the open circulatory system, I will explain you a closed, because it is easy to understand. So what is called as closed circulatory system? Closed circulatory system, that means here in such animals the blood is flowing into a closed system. Closed systems means they are flowing into arteries, veins, capillary. एक क्या थी ब्रेक नहीं हो, क्या थी पंक्चर नहीं हो, बद्दी एक बीजा जो कनेक्टेड है, इट इज अ क्लोज्ड सिस्टम. सो ब्लड इज फ्लोइंग इनटू दिस क्लोज्ड सिस्टम, क्या थी बाहर भी नहीं निकले. ओके, क्लियर? अनलेस एंड अंटिल इट इज नॉट डैमेज्ड, बराबर. जहां सुधी डैमेज नहीं था, क्या थी ब्लड क्या थी बाहर भी नहीं निकले, बराबर. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज क्लोज सिस्टम. सो इन अ क्लोज सिस्टम द ब्लड इज फ्लोइंग इनटू आर्टरीज, वेन्स एंड कैपिलरीज. कैपिलरीज आर द वेरी स्मॉल. Okay, so the arteries, veins and the capillaries. Whereas in the open circulatory system, the blood is flowing or the organs are bathed in the body cavities where the blood is flowing. So in an open circulatory system, the blood is flowing into a body cavities, okay, the open system, okay, where the organs are bathed within it, and thus they get the nutrient from it. So this is the difference. In the open circulatory system, the blood pressure, what we are commonly call as BP, the blood pressure, the pressure of blood which is flowing in it is a low, but in a closed circulatory system, the blood pressure is high. Okay, so in this closed circulatory system, the blood pressure is high. Now, which are the examples of an open circulatory system? The example of open circulatory system is arthropoda. This is the example of an open circulatory system. And the examples of closed circulatory system, the examples are annelida, okay, chordata, okay, these are the examples. I am just saying a few examples. You just have to remember this, annelida and the chordata, okay. So they are the examples of a closed circulatory system. And the arthropoda, like cockroach that comes under the arthropoda, they have an open circulatory system. Okay, so there are two kind of a system can be found, digestive and the circulatory, and these are their types. Okay, so these examples you have to remember. Cellular level of organization in porifera, I just repeat so you can remember a name. Tissue level of organization in collenterata. Organ level of organization in platyhelminthes. Organ system level of organization in annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, chordata. Two kind of digestive system, incomplete and the complete. Incomplete has just one opening, complete has two opening, and these are the examples. Circulatory system, open and closed. In a closed, they are flowing into a closed system. In open, they are flowing into a body cavities, and these are the examples. Okay, so this is about the first criteria by which animal can be classified, called as level of organization. Okay, now we are moving ahead with the second criteria based on which the animals can be classified. So let's go with the second criteria. So in the second criteria, the animal can be classified based on the symmetry. Okay, so there are how many types of symmetry are there? So if you see that, there are three types of a symmetry that exist. The first one, it's called as asymmetry. The second one is, it's called as radial symmetry. And the third, last one, it's called as bilateral symmetry. How many types of symmetry exist? Three: asymmetry, radial symmetry, and the bilateral symmetry. What do we mean by the asymmetry? In the asymmetry, the plane cannot divide living organism or animals into equal half. Means if you pass the plane through their body, then they cannot be divided into equal parts. They are called as asymmetry. Such kind of symmetry is called as asymmetry, and this kind of symmetry is found in sponges, or you can say a phylum Porifera. This kind of symmetry is found. Second is radial symmetry. Means radial symmetry, that means any plane, remember, any plane passing through the center divide animals into equal half. कोई भी प्लेन ले लो तमे एनी बॉडी कोई भी रीते डिवाइड करो लाइक लॉन्जिट्यूडिनल प्लेन ट्रांसवर्स प्लेन डायगोनल प्लेन एनी वे यू डिवाइड देयर बॉडी कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू इक्वल हाफ बराबर छे दिस इज कॉल्ड एज रेडियल सिमेट्री एंड दिस इज सच काइंड ऑफ अ सिमेट्री कैन बी फाउंड इन इकिनोडर्मेटा लाइक आई विल गिव यू एग्जांपल स्टारफिश यू माइट हैव सीन द स्टारफिश Roberts, suppose this is an example of a starfish, like look like this. So any plane when it is passing through the center, divide by any way, it can be divided into equal half. Such kind of a symmetry, it's called as radial symmetry. Clear? Next, last type of symmetry, you can say that it is a bilateral symmetry. So here, in the radial symmetry, any plane can divide into equal half. In asymmetry, it cannot be divided into equal half. In a bilateral symmetry, it can be divided into equal half, but through only one plane. Okay? Here any plane, but in bilateral, through only one plane. So here, it can be divided into equal half through only one plane बराबर छे the examples annelida arthropoda they have a bilateral symmetry or see the example of a human being like in human being if you divide this human being like this through this plane then there are two equal half But if you divide the animals from this plane, there are not two equal half. Upper part and lower part of a body is not equal half. So arm divide karo to na equal half tha. But jo arm divide karo to equal half tha. Means they have a bilateral symmetry. Equal half generate thai chai, but through only one plane. But in radial symmetry, koi bhi baju thi divide karo. They can be divided into equal half. Like it can be seen in echinodermata. Or like example starfish. So this is the second criteria by which the animals can be classified, the symmetry. Okay? Now moving ahead with the third criteria for the classification of animal, and this is called as you can say diploblastic and the triploblastic. Okay? So the layers, how many layers are present in them? Based on the presence of layer, there are two types of animals. First is called as diploblastic and the second one is called as triploblastic. Okay, so what is a diploblastic? Here the word you can say di means they have a two layers. Okay, they have a two layers. Which are the two layers they can be found? The outer layer in such animal is ectoderm and the inner layer is an endoderm. So there are only two layers are found in their organization. So such kind of animals, you can say that they have a diploblastic organization. Which two layer? Outer ectoderm. Remember the ectoderm is outer. And the endoderm, that is the inner. So the inner layer is endoderm. So when there are only two layers are found, such kind of organization is called as diploblastic organization. And this level of organization is found in the example Coelenterata has diploblastic organization. Now here the name itself suggests the next is triploblastic means they have a three layers. The outer is ectoderm, the inner is endoderm, and the middle one is mesoderm. So they have a three layers. They have a three layers: ectoderm, mesoderm, and the endoderm. Such kind of organization you can say that triploblastic organization. And there are many examples. So the examples of triploblastic are, which are the examples? You can say that platyhelminthes. I do not have a space, so I am not writing all this. Platyhelminthes, Aschelminthes, Whatever the animal that falls above the platyhelminthes, they all have a trachyloblastic. That means platyhelminthes, eschelminthes, annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, chordata, they all have a trachyloblastic organization. Only the collenterata has diploblastic organization, in which you can only find the two layers, where in all rest you can find the trachyloblastic organization, means three layers. So this is the third criterion. The first is level of organization, cellular level, tissue, organ, organ system. Second is symmetry, three kind of symmetry, asymmetry, radial symmetry, bilateral symmetry. Third criteria is the layers, diploblastic and the trachyloblastic. Okay, so now we are moving ahead with another criteria for classification. The fourth criteria for the classification of animal is the presence or absence of coelom. Coelom means, in the single term or simple word, you can say that body cavity. This body cavity is present between body wall and gut wall. Okay, there is a body cavity present between the body wall and the gut wall. This is called as coelom. Based on presence and absence of this coelom, the animals can be classified into three types. Okay, first is called as acoelomates. Second one, it's called as pseudocoelomates. And the last one, it's called as coelomates. Clear? The name itself suggests acoelomates. They do not have, coelom. Means they do not have a body cavity between the body wall and the gut wall. Do not have. Now I say the example coelomates. It's very easy. So they have, or they possess coelom. Means in these animals, this category of animal, the body cavity can be found. And the pseudocoelomate, pseudo means a false, means they don't have a body cavity, but there is a something which appear like a body cavity. Means it gives a false appearance. Actually ma na ho, but tamne hoy evu lage. So this is called as false appearance. You might be seeing that when you are going through a road, particularly in the desert area, तो रस्ता में पानी हो एवं लगे पर रियली त्या होतु नथी सच काइंड ऑफ फॉल्स फीलिंग अकर सो सेम हियर दे डोंट रियली दे डोंट हैव अ बॉडी कैविटी बट इट अपीयर लाइक दे हैव अ बॉडी कैविटी सो व्हाट सुडोकोलोमस इट गिव्स अ फॉल्स अपीयरेंस आई एम राइटिंग इन द सिंपल वर्ड इट गिव्स अ फॉल्स अपीयरेंस ऑफ बॉडी कैविटी Meaning really they don't have, but they give a false appearance of body cavity. So based on the presence or absence of coelom, the animals can be classified into three types: acoelomates, pseudocoelomates, and the coelomates. Acoelomates do not have body cavity, pseudocoelomates have a false appearance of a body cavity, and the coelomates, they have a body cavity or the coelom. Now the examples. Examples of acoelomate. The example is platyhelminthes. They have a body cavity. Sorry, they don't have a body cavity. Now the example of pseudocoelomate is a eschelminthes. Again, another variety of a worm. Worm or helminths. And the example of coelomates, all other like annelida, I'm just writing in the short, annelida to chordata. Means annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, chordata, they all have body cavities. Okay, so they are called as coelomates. So based on presence of or absence of coelom, three varieties: acoelomates, pseudocoelomates, and coelomates. This is the fourth criterion for classification of animals. Now we are moving ahead. Okay, the fifth criteria, you can say that it is metameric segmentation. Okay, so the fifth criteria, you can say that it is metameric segmentation. Metameric segmentation, that means you know that our body is divided into different segments, parts like head, thoracic region, abdomen, lower part of a body, like these are the segments. But when same kind of a division occurs externally, bharti, and the internally, then such kind of a segments or division is called as metameric segmentation. એટલે એમની બોડી બહારથી ને અંદરથી બે બાજુથી એક સરખી ડિવાઇડેડ હોય. આપણી બોડી બહારથી ડિવાઇડેડ છે હેડ થોરાસિક, પણ અંદર તો બધું એક સિંગલ કમ્પાર્ટમેન્ટ. ઓકે, સો ધીસ ઇઝ નોટ અ મેટામેરિક સેગમેન્ટેશન. બટ ઇફ ઇન ધ એનિમલ, એનિમલ ઇઝ ડિવાઇડેડ એક્સટર્નલી એઝ વેલ એઝ ઇન્ટરનલી ઇન ટુ અ સેગમેન્ટ્સ, લાઈક યુ કેન સી અર્થવોર્મ. ઇફ યુ સી ધ અર્થવોર્મ, ધેર બોડી ઇઝ ડિવાઇડેડ. ઇફ યુ સી ધ કોક્રોચ, ધેર બોડી ઇઝ ડિવાઇડેડ એક્સટર્નલી એઝ વેલ એઝ ઇન્ટરનલી. So such kind of example are called as metameric segmentation. So what is a metameric segmentation? Here the animal body divides into segment externally and internally. Such kind of division, equal external and internal segments, just such kind of a division is called as metameric segmentation. This is the fifth category. So those who have a metameric segmentation, the examples are Annelida and the Arthropoda. You can only find the metameric segmentation in Annelida and Arthropoda, whereas in rest all other, the metameric segmentation is not found. Means their body is not divided into equal segments externally and internally. Okay, so this is the another criteria for division, metameric segmentation. Okay, now we are moving ahead with the last criteria for the classification of animal, and it is a presence or absence of notochord. So next is presence or absence of notochord. Based on this, the animals can be classified into two types. Those who don't have a notochord, they are called as non-chordates. Those who have a notochord, they are called as chordates. So if the notochord is bound, notochord means it's a kind of a hollow structure you can find on the dorsal side of body usually. Where it is found, the notochord is present on the dorsal side of body. Okay, like in our case, this is the ventral and this one is called as dorsal. So if the notochord is present on the dorsal side, like we have on a spinal cord, so that is acting as a notochord. So if the notochord is present, then they are called as chordates. If notochord is absent, then they are called as non-chordates. So these non-chordates means they do not have notochord. Okay, and their examples are, which are the examples, like Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, they do not have a notochord. But if they have a notochord, then they are called as chordates. And the examples of chordates are, they have a notochord, that's chordata. Chordata includes lots of different classes. Like I just give you the different examples of, or different classes of chordates. Like for an example, you can say fishes, amphibians, they all fall under the chordates, amphibians, or you can say reptiles, birds, mammals. We falls under the mammals because we have a mammary gland. Okay, so these all are the classes of chordata. Chordata is a phylum, and these are all their classes. Okay, you know the division: species, genus, family, order, class, phylum. These all are the phylum. Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, even the chordata, they are the phylum. And in this chordata, these are the classes. Okay, fishes, amphibians, reptiles. So all these have a notochord. So they falls under the chordata. Okay, so this is the different criteria for the classification of living organism. If you remember this criteria and their examples, then it will be a lot easier. The whole chapter will be covered very easily. So you have to repeatedly repeat the or watch this video repeatedly, and then you have to prepare it. So it may happen that for the first time you find somewhat difficult to remember a names, but anyhow you have to remember it. Okay, so remember this. So animals can be classified in different criteria. First criteria is the level of organization. Second is symmetry. Third, you can say that the layers, diploblastic and triploblastic. Fourth, coelom. Next, segmentation. And the last one is notochord. Okay, so based on this, the animals can be classified, and we will learn this characteristic in all the variety of animals. Okay, from next lecture onward, we will start the individual phylum and their characteristic with its example. Okay, so that's all about it, the first session of the animal kingdom. Student, prepare it thoroughly. It will be a lot helpful in the preparation of whole chapter. Okay, so for today we are ending here. So keep learning, keep watching, and like and subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching.